Welcome back, everyone. In this video, we will cover how to execute R and Python code in SQL Server with Machine Learning Services. If you don't already have ML services installed and enabled, check out the description below for links to learn how to get set up. All right, let's get to it. Open SQL Server Management Studio. Let's talk about a real simple example. You can copy-paste this code from the video description below. SPExecute external script is a special system stored procedure that enables R and Python execution in SQL. There is a language parameter that allows us to choose between Python and R. For today's video, I decided to share examples in Python, but almost everything works the same for R. There is a script parameter where you can paste your R or Python code. Let's execute this example. If you do not see a result of 7, please review our previous videos or visit the documentation link below. Now that we ran this simple example, let's start adding more pieces. Machine Learning Services provides more natural communications between SQL and R or Python with an input data parameter that accepts any SQL query. For input data, the parameter name is input data 1. You can see in the Python code that there are default variables defined to pass data between Python and SQL. The default variable names are output dataset and input dataset, unless you decide to change them, like this example. See how I gave them an arbitrary name in the parameters, and then adjusted my Python code as well? Let's execute this example. Have you noticed how each of these examples returns a result with no column name? You can specify a name for the columns that are returned by adding this to the end of the statement, with results sets, which is a comma-separated list of column names and their data types. All right, let's discuss a little more about the input and output data types used between SQL and Python. Your input SQL select statement passes a data frame to Python relying on the Python pandas package. Your output from Python back to SQL also needs to be in a pandas data frame object. If you need to convert from scalar values into a data frame, here's two examples. Here, variables C and D are both scalar, which you can add to a pandas series if you like, and then convert them to a pandas data frame. This one shows a little bit more of a complicated example. Please read up on the pandas documentation for more examples. Congratulations, you now know the basics to execute R in Python and T-SQL. Feel free to like this video, leave a comment below to ask questions, or even tell us about the awesome ways you have operationalized machine learning in your SQL databases.